This conference will now be recorded.
Let's start. Right, so in the last class, we discussed about what, how to enable or disable the module pool programs, right? A module pool screen element. So if you go to Object Navigator, let me open that program. Is it the same server? Let me open this, let me execute. Employee number. Okay, so if I give employee number, when I click on get data, we are getting the data and we are making these fields as what? Enabled and what? Disabled, visible, invisible, all this. So we understood this technique. Now similarly, if you go back to your table maintenance, CL, what is the T code for maintaining the table? SM30. So if I go to SM30, try to understand, see the another requirement. Related to table maintenance, when you are generating the table maintenance, we have to give the maintenance type. Maintenance type will be either what, one step or what, two step. Maintenance type will be either one step or two step. So two step is what happens, two screens will be generated, overview screen and what, a single screen. Okay, in overview screen we can perform the operations like view, delete and what, update. And in single screen, we can insert the data. So if I go to SM30, okay, in SM30, right? So in SM30, let me give some table name, Z930 underscore EMP. When I click on maintain button, okay, when I click on the maintain button, yeah, this is your overview screen. Okay, and if I click on new entries, this is your single screen. So anyhow, we know how to design this particular screen. Now if you go back to the screen, you can see here we are able to see multiple records. This control is nothing but called as table control. Okay, so your transaction might contain what? A screen element called as what? Table control. Okay, what is the purpose of table control? It is used for displaying number of records in the form of what, rows and what, columns. Okay, here this is single screen where we have input fields. Input fields can store only what, can show only what, one value. This entire thing is one record only, but these are what, multiple records. So what is our agenda now? We need to understand how to develop the module pool transaction, which contains what, table control component. Okay. Already in module pool, we know how to work with text fields and what, input fields. So here, if you see, this is the requirement. See, I want a transaction where, where I should have the input fields like this and I should have the table control like this. So we have the tables VBAK and what, VBAP, sales document header data and sales document item data. So my requirement is the user is going to enter what, sales document number. Whenever he presses enter, see here, on entering sales document and pressing enter key, get the corresponding header data and item data. Item data, I have to display it in the table control. So a sales document might contain multiple items, na? That item data should be displayed here. And this is your header data. Header data is always what, single record. So this header data should be displayed in these input fields and this item data. So the agenda here is what, how to develop a transaction which contains what, table control component, and how to populate the data in the table control component. Okay, so one second. Okay, one second, please. Yeah, so let me develop this particular module pool program. So I'll go to Object Navigator. Where do we develop the module program? Object Navigator. So I'll go to SC80. Right, so in the drop down, you have to choose what program. Then here, you have to give the program name. So I'll give the program name as something ztest-mpp3. Already we have seen two programs. So this is third program in module pool, ztest-mpp3. I'll press enter. Program does not exist. Create the object. Yes. I'll create the program with the top include so that I can declare global variables. I can define subroutines and module definitions. This is my program name. Continue. Provide the top include program name. I'll give it as Z what? Test MPP3 top. End with what? Top. Start with what? ZRY. Continue. So type of program is what? Module pool. Type of program is module pool. Let me save it. Save it in the local object. So this is important. This table control, just try to focus. So as of now, my program contains only what? Top include program. So I'll right click on the program and I'll say create. What is the first thing I have to do? Create the screen. Okay, so I'll right click on the program, create what? Screen. I'll give the screen number as something what? 100. Screen number is 100. Continue. Provide the description. I'll just give some description. In the attributes tab only, you have to provide the description. Choose a type of the screen. What is the type of the screen? Normal screen. Let us design the layout for the screen. So I'll click on the layout button. So if you visualize the requirement here, my table control should contain some input fields referring to the fields of VBAK table and table control referring to the fields of what? VBAP table. So on my screen layout, just try to understand. I require fields from which table? VBAK table and fields from what? VBAP table. So from VBAK table, how many fields I want? 4 fields: sales document number, date, time, and created by. From VBAP also I require what? 4 fields. So I can directly refer to what? I can directly refer to VBAK table. So if you go to SC11, I can refer to the table what? VBAK, which has got some 100 plus fields. Yeah, it has got some 287 fields. I want these 4 columns: webland, date, time, and what? Year, name. And similarly, if I go to VBAP sales document item table, it also has got what? Some fields. It has got some 405 fields, it seems. Done. Okay, so instead of referring to these tables, okay, already we know how to create the structures now. So I'm having one structure, ZCVBAK. This structure I might have created in the earlier batches. So, but anyhow, we know how to create the structure. We have seen it practically also. So this is the structure I created. This structure contains what? 4 fields. Webland, I'm using the standard data elements. So what are the fields? These are all the fields of VBAK table. So I'll refer to this structure, ZCVBAK, which has got what? 4 columns. And ZCVBAP, which also contains 4 columns. These are the fields from which table? VBAP table. In this also, I'm referring to the standard data element. So I'll refer to these two structures, ZCVBAK and ZCVBAP. Okay, so now I'll go back to my data module pool program. I'll design the screen. So how to first let us design this. First let us design this 4 input field. So on the layout, how to design? Choose, go to secondary window, dictionary slash program fields. Here it is asking the table name. So far we are giving the database table names. We can also give the structure names. What is the structure we are having? ZCVBAK. Okay, this is my own structure which I created containing 4 fields of VBAK table. So I'll take ZCVBAK get from database. Yes, these are the 4 columns. I want all the 4 columns. I'll put it on the screen. Done. Okay, so these are my 4 fields. Done. So first what I'll do is forget about table control. First I'll try to get the data from these fields. What are the validations I want? Sales document number field is what? Mandatory. This field should be made mandatory, it seems. If it is a selection screen, we would use the addition what? Obligatory. We would use the addition what? Obligatory. Okay. So what I'll do is, since this is a module pool transaction field, if you want to make this field as mandatory, double click on this input field. Double click on this input field. For this input field, what is the name of the field? ZCVBAK-Weblen, right? So you can see here, there is one parameter here. If you go to the program tab, there is a property here. In the program tab, input is here. Input, you change it to what required. Input property, you have to change it to what required in the program tab. So when I change it to required, you can say I got a question mark here indicating that it is a mandatory field. Let me save it, check for the syntax, activate this. And already we know, already we have seen in the last class, if you are using the screen fields in your program, you have to declare that field names in your program. But already we know, we have seen, I cannot have a variable names with hyphen. It cannot capture the value. So what I have to do, since it is designed from the database with so and so, it is proposing the name like that. But I cannot refer to this name directly in my program, or else let me keep it as it is. Let me refer for the timing. Save it. I'll take one exit button because I'll not have a back button. So I'll take one exit button somewhere here. I'll give the function code as name as B1. Text I'll give it as exit. Function code I'll give it as what? FC1. Done. Let me save it. Check for the syntax. Activate this. Right. So first let us write the logic for the exit button. Whenever we click on the button, what is the event triggered? PAI. Already we know this in the flow logic. I'll uncomment the PAI event module. Double click on the PAI event module. PAI module does not exist. Create the object. Let me choose the top include program. Continue. Write the required logic. So already we know this logic. So I'll just say case IU com. What? When FC1. I'll say what? Leave program. Leave program and what? End case. Done. Let me save it. Check for the syntax. Activate. Come back and activate your flow logic. Flow logic is activated. Then I'll right click on the program and I have to create the T code. Na? So right click on the program, create the T code. I'll give the T code name as something ZTM3. Provide the short description. T code for MPP3. Continue. What is the program name? ZTestMPP3. Screen number is what? Unread. Let me select the checkbox SAPGA for Windows. Save it. Activate you have already we know all these things, so I'm not repeating. Activate this. Done. Now let us try to execute this program. Done. So I'll try to exit. I got an error. Fill in all the required, because this is a mandatory field, so compulsory I have to provide some value. Okay, then only I can exit. Done. How to do forceful exit, we'll see it later on. Done. So we are able to exit. Now what is my first requirement? The user is going to enter some sales document. When I press enter, I should get the corresponding data. Okay. Do we have any F4 help for this? When I execute, when I press F4, it is saying no input help is available, because if you see this screen, what is the name of the field? ZCVBAK-Weblen. So if you go back to that structure, ZCVBAK, what is the field we are referring? Weblen. What is the data element? Weblen underscore VA. If I double click on this, at the data element, if I go to further characteristics, we don't have any search help attached. But if you go to the domain level, in the domain level, in the value range tab, if you scroll down, there is something called as value table. What is the value table here? VB UK it seems. VB UK. So we are having some value table, but still we are not getting any FRL. So what I'll do now, just see this. I'll come back to the FRL later on. What is the requirement now? When I enter some value here, when I press enter, I should get the corresponding edit and display it. So forget about this screen. Assume that this is your selection screen. Assume that this is a selection screen. If you press enter key in the selection screen input field, if you press enter key in the selection screen input field, what are the events triggered? Anyone? If you press enter key in the selection screen input field, what are the events triggered? Anyone? If you press enter key in the selection screen input field, what are the events triggered? What is the first event triggered? At selection screen on field. Then the next event triggered is what? At selection screen. Then the next event triggered is what? At selection screen output. So in case of selection screen, whenever you press enter key in the input field, they are the events triggered one after the other. In case of module pool, the first event triggered is PAI, and after PAI it will trigger what? PBO. This comparison is important. Then only will become strong in ABAP. Okay. In case of selection screen, there are the three events triggered one after the other. In case of module pool, there are the two events triggered. What is the first event triggered? PAI, process after input. So what I'll do now, what is the name of that screen field? ZCVBAK hyphen what? Weblen is the name of that field. So since I know that PA event is triggered, in the PA event, in the flow logic, in the PA event, you have to say field. Try to understand field. Okay, or I can write it somewhere here. What is that field? What is the field name? ZCVBAK hyphen Weblen. Hyphen Weblen module field name module get what? Sales header data. Get sales header data. I am defining my own module. What is the syntax? Field name module module name. Field name module module name. So double click on this. PA module does not exist. Create the object. Yes, I'll create that in the top include program. Continue. Do you want to save it? Yes. Now write the logic. What is the logic here? Based on this field value, I should get the rest of the data. So what I have to do now? Anyhow, we are going to enter the sales document, which is the primary key in the VBAK table. So when you're comparing with primary key, you'll get only single record. So select single. We are going to enter the Weblen. Rest of the fields I have to get now. Select single or select single what? Weblen again. Also what? ERDAT. ERZET, ERNAM, from which table? From VBAK into what are my screen field names? ZCVBAK hyphen Weblen, ZCVBAK hyphen ERDAT, and then what? ZCVBAK hyphen ERZET, ZCVBAK hyphen ERNAM. Okay, where Weblen equal to what? The entered Weblen. Where is the entered Weblen? ZCVBAK hyphen Weblen. That's all. Okay, so save it. Check for the syntax. I am getting an error. Field ZCVBAK hyphen Weblen is what? Unknown. So these are my screen field names. If you are using screen fields in the program, we should declare that screen field. So I should declare the screen fields. So how to declare now? What should be the variable name? ZCVBAK hyphen Weblen type. ZCVBAK hyphen Weblen. This is the way I have to declare. So when I do syntax check, I am getting an error. ERDAT is what? Unknown. So let me declare the rest of the fields also. ERZET what year NaM. Here also what year DAT, this also year ZDT, and this also what year NaM. Done. So save it, check for the syntax error. I got a warning, the hyphen character cannot appear in the names. So the variable names cannot contain what hyphen. It's only a warning. I'll try to ignore. So let me check whether I'll get the data or not. So I repeat once again, whenever I press enter key in the module pull screen input field, what is the event triggered? PI. So since for that field I have to execute that module, what is the syntax? Field name, module name. So what I am doing, I am getting these four fields from VBA table. I am transferring into my screen fields. This screen field should be declared. So I declared it. Let's see whether I'll get the data or not. So activate this, activate your flow logic, activate your entire program. Done, execute this. Done, so this is my blend. Right, so I'll say 4980, I'll press enter. I didn't got the data, So let me try to debug. I'll put the breakpoint in this module. Done. Execute direct processing. So I'll enter 4980, I'll press enter. What is the event triggered? Yes, PA event is triggered. So what is the webline I entered? 4980 na ZCVBAK-webline is what? Nothing is there. First of all, it is not capturing that field value in my variable, because my variable name is what? Containing what? Hyphen. So when I execute, my select will be failed. Size of bars is what? 4, because webline is what? Blank here. So what is the understanding? Never we should declare the variable names with what? Hyphen. Never we should declare the variable names with what? Hyphen. So this is, it is not going to capture the data. So what I'll do, I'll comment this. So I'll just give a comment here. What is this? Does not what? Capture data. So what I have to do now, I will say tables ZC VBA again. So this already we know, tables statement will create a work area with all these fields. How many fields this structure contains? 4 fields. So even that creates a work here with all the 4 fields, no problem here, because anyway I'm going to use what? All the 4 fields. If I say tables VBAK, it's a problem. Unless it will create a work here with the 287 fields. After 287, we might use only 4 fields. That's the reason I have not designed from VBAK, I have designed from my own structure. So I'll say ZC VBAK done. So I don't have any warnings related to that what field names. Done. So let's see whether I'll get the data or not. Okay, I'll say 4980, I'll press enter. I got the data. Understood, I got the data here. Okay, I got the data. What is the next requirement now? Okay, I'll enter something A4980, I'll press enter. I don't have any data, right? So I'll give 4985. I'll press enter. I got the data working fine. So now apart from the header data, I require what? Item data also, no? So each sales document might contain what? Multiple items. So let us design the table control. So before I continue, any questions so far, please ask me. So whenever we press enter key in the module pull screen input field, the event triggered is what? PAI. First event triggered is PA. Next event is what? PBO. Now let us design the table control. So I'll go to the layout. So these are the input fields which I designed from my dictionary structure. Now on the toolbox you can see we have what? A screen element. We have a control called as table control. Take the table control, draw it on the screen, right? This is my table control. Every control we have to give a name now. So let me give the name for this table control. I'll double click on this. I get the property window. I should give the name for my table control. I should give the name for the table control. So let me double click. I'll give the name as TBCTRL. I'll give the name as TBCTRL. Any name you can give, I am giving it as a TBCTRL. I'll press enter. Even after giving the name, the color is not changed because my table control doesn't have any fields. On the table control, we should always display the columns, no? So I should associate the columns. Then only the table control is complete. So the name is TVCTRL, done. Now, acha, you can see here for the table control only, we have some properties here. Vertical property and what horizontal property. Let me select the what checkboxes. Okay, so that the separators you'll get. Vertical scrolling property and horizontal scrolling property. I cannot see it properly here. Once I place the columns, you'll see. Otherwise, initially I'm not selecting this vertical, I'll keep it blank. So now I have to place the fields from which table now? Item table now. What is the table? VBAP. Instead of placing it from VBAP, I'll place it from my own structure, ZC VBAP. So I'll choose go to secondary window, dictionary program fields. I'll give the structure name, table name is what? So what I'm trying to show is I can design the database fields either by referring to the table or by referring to what structure also. So I'll say ZC VBAK get from dictionary. Then I want the four fields. I'll select the four fields, done. I'll drop it on my table control. It will come as columns. Let me reduce the size. Right. Okay. Now I will set the separators. I'll double click on my table control. Name is TV settle. I'll give vertical separator. I'll give horizontal separator. Done. So my table control is designed. What is the name of this one? ZCVBAPFN Webler. What is the name of this? ZCVBAPFN POSNR. This is ZCVBAPFN MATNR. This is ZCVBAPFN NETWR. Done. So I have designed my table control. So I'll repeat this. I place the table control on the screen. I named it as TBCTRL. Then I place the columns from what? ZCVBAP structure, which is my own structure, which has got some four fields. After placing the fields, I've set the vertical separator and horizontal separator for my table control. Done. Let me check whether I'll get any design time errors. I'll save it. Check for the syntax error. Yes, when I do the syntax check, I'm getting an error. The field ZCVBAPFN Webland is not assigned to a loop. The field ZCVBAPFN Webland is not assigned to a loop. Loop and loop must appear in PBO and what? PI. Loop and loop must appear in PBO and what? PI itself. So understand like this. Whenever your screen contains table control component, you'll place the columns in that component. What are the column names? ZCVBAPFWebland. So when I do the syntax check, I'll get an error saying that it is not assigned loop and end loop. So to avoid this error, what you have to do is initially, just to avoid the error, in the PBO event, say loop and loop. In the flow logic section, in the PBO event, just say loop and loop. In the PA also, say loop and end loop. Why? We'll understand going forward. Just say loop and end loop initially, just to avoid that particular syntax error. Save it, check it. Now I don't have any syntax error. Activate this. So what I did, I repeat. I place the table control on the screen. I gave the name of the table control as TBCTRL. I placed four columns from the dictionary structure ZCVBAP. Then I set the vertical and horizontal separator. When I was trying to do the syntax check, we are getting an error. Loop and loop must appear in both PBO and what? PI. So just to avoid the syntax error, initially you assign what? Loop and loop for both PBO and what? PI. Activate this. So let's see whether it works or not. Okay, any questions before I continue? Done. Okay, so let me activate this. Let me try to execute this. Right click on the program and I'll say activate. So when I try to execute, right click on the program, execute direct processing, right? What is the name of my table control? TBCTRL. So when I try to execute, I'll get a runtime error. control variable not found. Control variable not found. What is the error analysis? Search is performed for the control tbctrl. Okay, on the screen, I place the table control, I gave the name as tbctrl. So I'll get an error, what? Control not found. So whenever your screen contains table control component, I repeat, whenever your screen contains table control component, that table control component should be declared explicitly. Otherwise, you will get a runtime error, control not found. So what I have to do to avoid this runtime error is, in your top include program, where do we declare all the global variables? In the top include program. I'll go to the top include program. In my top include program, I need to declare the table control. So how to declare the table control? So far, we are declaring the variables by using data keyword. Now these special controls, like table control, should be declared by using the keyword controls. Controls, what is the name I gave for table control? tbctrl, type table view using screen. On which screen you have placed under it? So I declare the table control. Controls, control name, right? Type table view using screen 100. So the data type for table control is what? Table view. So why we should declare? Whenever your screen contains table control component, explicitly we should declare the table control by using what keyword? Controls keyword. What is the data type for table control? Table view using screen. On which screen we have placed the table control? Screen number is what? 100. That's all. Activate your flow logic. Right click on the program, activate the program, right click on the program, execute direct processing. Done. Okay, no errors. Now I'll enter what? 4980. When I press enter, I got the header data. I should also get the item data now. So when I press enter, what is the event triggered here? PAI. Already I wrote the logic for PAI now. So I'll go to the flow logic, double click on the screen. This is my flow logic. Field name, module. Module name. I should define the module to get the header data as well as item data. So I'll say, if my header data is available, if size of bars is equal to what? 0 means if my selection is successfully executed, if the header data is available, obviously you may add the item data. So I have to get what? Item data now. Okay, so each sales document might contain n number of items now. So I should declare an internal table. So in the top include program only, let me declare the internal table for holding the items. I'll say types. How many fields I should take? 4 fields. I'll say types begin of. What is the name of that ty underscore? I'll say something what items. Ty underscore items. Here I will include the structure. Instead of declaring those fields one by one, I'll just include the structure ZC VBAP, include types one. So then I'll say types what? End of TY underscore what? Items. End of TY underscore items. Done. Let me declare the internal table. Done. So I declare the internal table and what? Work area. Okay, my internal table contains how many fields? 4 fields. How do we include the dictionary structure? By using what? Include type, or else I can use include structure. But include structure is absolute in what? Object oriented, not supported in object oriented. So I can use include type anywhere. Okay, so include type. So ZC, what is there? VBAP, ZC VBAP. Done. So I will have the internal table now. Let us get the data. So size of bars equal to 0. I'll get the data now. I'll say What are the fields? Select Webblend. Select Webblend. What else? Fields, item fields, PYSNR, material number, NETWR from VBAP into table. What is the internal table? T underscore items, where, what is the common field? Where Webblend equal to, right? Where Webblend equal to what? ZCVBAK hyphen Webblend. So I'll get the item data. So where is the item data will come and sit? It will come and sit in this particular internal table. Okay, from this internal table, I need to populate it to my table control. Okay, so first of all, let me debug and check whether I'm getting the item data or not. So I'll put the breakpoint here. I'll enter 4980. I'll press enter. Yeah, it is going there. I'll get the header data anyhow. Now I'm trying to get the item data. Do you have any data now? As of now, it is empty. When I execute the select statement, when I say F5, yes, I got the four items. So those four items are there in this internal table now. So from this internal table, I need to populate it to what? My table control. So the data is there in what? Internal table. What is the internal table name? T underscore items. I need to populate it to what? My table control. So what I have to do here, see the logic here. Already it's there. Yeah, so what is my internal table? T underscore what? VBAP. Okay, let me take the name as VBAP. Items also is fine, but diagram is already there. So I'll say D underscore TY underscore what? VBAP. Here also I'll say TY underscore VBAP. T underscore VBAP, W underscore VBAP, TY underscore VBAP, and this is TY underscore VBAP, done. Right, so now when I'm getting the data into T underscore VBAP, so the data is there in what? Internal table, but I should populate it to what? Table control fields. I should populate it to table control fields. What are my table control fields? If you go to the layout, if I double click on this, what is the name of the field? ZCVBAP-Webblend. This is ZCVBAP-PYSNR, ZCVBAP-MATNR, and this is -NETWR. So I need to populate the data to that particular table control fields. The data is in the internal table. So what I'll do, already we know after executing PA, the next event triggered is what? PBO. So in PA, we are getting the data. Already I told you in the last class, the screen refreshing logic should always be written in the final event which is getting triggered. So in case of module pull, what is the final event which gets triggered? PBO, process before output. So in PA, get the data, populate the data in what? The final event, that is PBO. So now control goes to PBO. Already in PBO, we are loop end loop now. So you have to loop the internal table, loop at, what is the internal table? T underscore VBAP into what is the work area declared? W underscore VBAP. Okay, loop at T underscore VBAP into work area. This is what the syntax we know so far for loop and end loop. Now I'll say with control, what is the name of the table control? TBCTRL. So what is the meaning of that? While looping the internal table, you also loop the table control. That is the meaning of that. While looping the internal table, you also loop the table control. That is the meaning of that, with the control answer. So when you loop here, what happens? Each record will come to work area like this. Each record will come to work area. Okay. From work area, what you have to do? We have to assign the data from work area to what? Table control fields. Since we are in the loop, control will automatically go to second record. And while I'm looping, I'm also telling SAP to also loop what? Table control. So the control goes to the second record in the table control. The data will be transferred. This is the way to populate the data in the table control. What is the logic? Loop your internal table. When you loop, what happens? data will come to what? Work area. From work area, you assign it to a table control. So while looping the internal table, parallelly, I should loop the table control also so that the cursor goes to next row. That's the reason we have to use this syntax with the control so and so. This syntax I cannot use wherever I want. This syntax is recognized only in the PBO event in the flow logic section. I cannot use it wherever I want. So when a loop is called, will come to work area. So I need to transfer the data from work area to table control fields. What are my table control fields? ZC, VB, APF and Weblen, ZC, VB, APF and POSNR, all those things. So I cannot write the logic here. Just I'll write some module inside loop and end loop. I will say I'll create my own module. Module transfer items. Transfer items data. Okay. This module gets executed for every record. Okay. In flow logic screen, I cannot write the entire logic. It will not recognize. It will recognize only few keywords like loop, end loop, module, field, those things. Okay. So module, module name. Let me double click on that. PBO model does not exist. Create the object. Yes. I'll create that in the top include program. Do you want to save? Yes. Right. So what are my table control fields? ZC, VB, API, and so on and so, all those things. So let me declare that. So here I'll say tables. What? ZC, VB, AK, comma. What else? ZC, VB, AP. This will also create what? Work area. Then I'll say, here I'll say clear ZCVBAP. I'll say ZCVBAP-Weblen equal to, we are in the work here, we are in the loop only, na WAP-VBLN. ZCVBAP-POSNR item number equal to W_VBAP-POSNR. Then ZCVBAP-material number equal to W_VBAP-material number. ZCVBAP-NETWR equal to W_VBAP-NETWR. Done. Okay. So done. So I'm looping the internal table. When loop here, each record will come to work area. For every record, this module gets executed. Now, what is the logic I'm writing in the module? Data should be assigned from work area to your table control field. These are table control fields. Whenever you're using the screen fields, I should declare them. Already declared them now. How I declared? By using what? Tables keywords. Done. So this will work now. Let me save, check, no errors. Okay, so this is important. When you press enter key, what is the event triggered? PAI is the event triggered. In the PAI, this module gets executed first. I'm getting the header data, transferring it to my input fields. If the header data is available, I'm getting the item data into the internal table. After triggering PI, it goes to what? PBO. In the PBO only, we have to write the logic to populate the data to your table control. How do you populate the data? Loop your internal table along with the table control. For every record in the internal table, this module gets executed. So the data is assigned from work area to your table control field. So let me activate everything, execute now. So when I enter 4980, I'll press enter. I got the header data and what? Item data. I got the header data and what? Item data. Okay, so how do we edit the data in this? All those things will come in the coming sessions. When you go to populating the data BDC using table control, again we'll see all those examples. Okay, this data, whatever I enter, I should be able to modify. This modified data should get updated in my what? Internal table, and then I should update it to a database table. So all those things we'll see that, but here our focus is only to populate the data into what? Internal table. To populate the data into the internal table. Okay, and one more observation here. I'm able to scroll horizontally in the table control. I'm able to scroll horizontal, but you can see I don't have the vertical scrolling. So SAP will not provide the vertical scrolling by default because SAP doesn't know how many records it has to scroll. It depends on how many records you are populating. Now, so we have to enable this vertical scrolling property. How do you enable? See here, when I'm getting the item data here, when I'm getting the item data, yeah, here I'm getting the data into this one. So here I'll say, if size of RC equal to 0, means if item data is found, what is the name of the table control? TBCTRL hyphen. Table control contains a property called as lines property. TBCTRL hyphen lines is equal to what? Psi dbcon. What is the psi dbcon will contain? It contains a count of number of records retrieved by your previous select statement. If the count is 5, that 5 it will what? Scroll how many lines? 5 lines. So this lines property will enable what? Enables what? Vertical scrolling. By default, vertical scrolling is disabled. Explicitly, we have to enable it by setting what? Lines property of the table control. Since lines is a property of table control, I must access it by using the name of the table control. Okay, so when I done, activate this, execute. I'll enter 4180, I'll press enter. Yes, okay, you can see now horizontal area is coming earlier also. I'm able to scroll what? Vertically also. So how do we enable the vertical scrolling? By using an addition, by using a property called as lines property. So here we understood today how to design the table control, how to populate the data in the table control. At the design time also, we will get an error saying that loop and loop is not available in PBO and PI. So to avoid that syntax error, in the design time itself, in both PBO and PI, we should write blank loop and what? End loop. Then how do you populate the data into the table control? Get the required data into the internal table. Get the required data into the internal table. Then as part of the PBO module, as part of the PBO event, we need to loop the internal table along with what? Table control, so that the cursor goes to next record in the table control also. For every record of this internal table, this module gets executed. What this module logic we wrote? We are assigning the data from work area to what? Your table control fields. That's all. So any questions on this population of data, please ask me. Done, huh? No questions. So going forward, what we'll do is we'll see all these things. Suppose here, if I go to my SM30, just observe here, SM30, this is my table. If I click on maintain, this is nothing but the table control. You can see here, I'm able to scroll what? Vertically, I'm able to scroll horizontally. When I'm scrolling horizontally, you can see here, only employee number and employee name is moving, not what? Employee number. Okay, scroll bar is not coming from employee number, it is coming from where? Employee name only. So these features we will be seeing going forward. In our case, what is happening? I am able to scroll from first column to what? Last column, you can see. But here I should make this column disabled, read only, and I should be able to scroll only from the second field. So all those things will be coming in the coming classes. But this data population is very important. Then only we can do the other things. So entry point of view, how do we assign the data to the table control means? What is our answer? Get the required data into the internal table. Then as part of PBO event, loop your internal table along with your table control. Then for every record of the internal table, you have to assign the data from work area to table control fields. How I did it? I have enclosed that logic inside what? A module statement. Done. Right, so I'll stop for today. Tomorrow we'll continue with what other things. So when now we understood everything related to what table control, sorry, table maintenance. Single screen contains what input fields. Overview screen contains what table control. Okay, so in dictionary objects we have to discuss some more things. Okay, we'll discuss that. Okay, like buffering, currency, quantity fields, authorization object. Right, so we'll discuss that. Let me check whether anything I have to cover related to table control, then I'll go to that. Okay, so we'll discuss that part tomorrow then. Any questions for today, please ask me. And one more thing before I wind off. Okay, anyway, I'll drop a mail. I'll drop a mail related to cross apps new batch in the weekends. Okay, so just let me know how many of you it is feasible. Saturdays and Sundays, morning 7 to 9, only 2 days, Saturdays and Sundays. Okay, so I'll drop a mail related to that cross application. Let me know your feedback. So based on that, I'll decide whether it is a regular batch or what, weekend batch. I'll decide accordingly. Okay, so probably I'll drop a mail either today or tomorrow. Based on that, based on your feedback, I'll decide in 4 or 5 days, and then I'll communicate. Okay. It's not forceful, it's only an option. We'll have a regular cross app batch also, but it may take some time. Okay, that's the reason there are other people asking for weekends. So just want to think of that. Okay, right? So we'll continue tomorrow then.